In today's tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how to use product attributes. There are two different types of attributes that you can use, one being custom, and that is specific to products that are not going to have global options. Maybe it's a special product that you don't need to create a global option for. And then there's also global attributes, which, you know, it's how it sounds. It can be used globally. But these are used for variable products in WooCommerce, and pretty much it just means that these products have options to select. So I'm going to show you how to create a custom attribute first. All right, so we're going to go to products, and we're going to go to add new. And we're just going to add our product name. All right. And then down here in the product data section, we're not going to focus on any of the other areas, but we're only going to focus on the product data section of these products. So we're going to change this to variable product. And if I try to go to the variations tab now, it's going to say, nope, you have to go to attributes tab first. So I'm going to go to attributes, and if I have created global attributes already, they would already be listed in here, which they are not because we are going to create them. So from this drop down, I'm just going to click add because we're creating a custom product attribute. So this is, we're just going to call this a custom option, and we want to use this for a variation. So we're going to make sure that's checked off. And from here, we're going to enter some values. So we're just going to do option one. And we're going to separate these with a pipe. Option two and option, I don't know how to spell. All right. So I'm going to save these attributes, and I'm going to expand this so you can see what it looks like. And that's it. So now I can go to variations, and from this drop down, I'm going to select create variations from all attributes and hit go. It's going to ask me if I want to, if I'm sure. Of course, I'm sure. I'm going to hit OK. Then it's going to let me know how many variations have been added. So I'll hit OK on that. All right. So from here, I can expand these, and I can enter in my price. I can enter in my weight and my dimensions. I can also enter in a description. If these were like specific styles, maybe, you know, specific material, whatever the case may be, I can upload an image for each particular variation as well. So it's pretty much just very straightforward. The only thing that is required is the price. So if you don't enter in anything else, that's okay. It is important to set, you know, weight and dimensions, especially if you're using the UPS or USPS or FedEx plugins, as they require weight and dimensions, or weight and or dimensions. You know, for their setup to calculate shipping. So so that's pretty much it. Once you have all of your options, or excuse me, variations filled out, you would just hit save changes, and then you can go about updating the rest of your you know, product data in here, and, you know, set a category, set your product image, maybe you have a gallery, and then you can hit publish, and it'll go right to your shop page. All right, so I'm gonna move this to the trash. And now we're going to add global attributes. So we're going to go to attributes under products. And because I've used size and color quite a bit, we're just going to type in color and add. Or I can just type in the attribute and hit enter. So now I have my attributes in here, but we need to add values. So to do that, we're going to want to configure the terms. All right. So from here, this is, we're going to do red, blue, green, yellow. All right. And if I want to show these alphabetically, I can change the order. As you can see, just drag and drop them, and that's all set. So we're going to go back to attributes, and we're going to do the same thing for our other attributes. So this is size. So we'll do small, medium, and large. And I'm gonna just change the order of these. And that's all for that. And then for style, we're gonna configure the terms. And we'll just do, and this would be like if we're creating like a, it's like a t-shirt design that has multiple different types of, you know, styles for, you know, printing on. So maybe you got, you know, a crew neck, or maybe you have a V-neck, maybe you have regular. But I'm just going to add these two in here for now. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go to add new. We're going to add a new product. Just going to give it a title and that's it. We're going to change this to variable product. And we're going to go to attributes first. And then from here, you'll see that we have global attributes that we can use. So we can use color. We can use style, or excuse me, size, and then style. And we want to use these for variations. And we're just going to select all of these, but you don't have to select all of the terms that are created. And you can also go back and add more terms to your global attributes. So we'll do select all, select all, and select all. Hit save attributes. And now we can go to variations and we can create variations from all attributes and hit go. It's going to ask me, am I sure? Of course, we're sure. Hit OK. And it's given us 24 variations. All right. So, so to pretty much explain this, these are grouping the color, the size, and the style all together. So as you can see, we have a green small crew neck, green small V-neck, green medium crew neck, so on and so forth. Okay. And I can expand all of these and enter in, you know, a price. And of course, my weight and dimensions, a description if I want to. I would definitely want to do a picture for these because this is showing a specific color. All right. And also a specific style too. So I'll do the color, you know, like green with a crew neck and then, you know, green with a V-neck. And I can just continue that process, you know, so on and so forth. But pretty much you want to make sure that all of your stuff is entered in here. And then once you get all the way down to the bottom, you have a couple of pages to go through. So first you're going to want to save your changes and then you can go to the next page to finish adding in all of your variation information. So that concludes, you know, using product attributes. If you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to our technical support team. They are available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And thank you very much.